Hello everyone, I am Lalit Sharma from the Venkateshwar School, Gurugram. In our last video, we discussed about the syllabus pattern for physics in case of NTSC stage 1 level 1 exam. Now we will discuss chapter wise explanation of the topics. Our first topic is light. So let's start. In this topic light, first we should know what is light. Light is a form of energy which enables us to see, by which we can see things. So this is light. What are the properties of light? Light travels in straight line. Light do not require any medium to propagate. Speed of light is 3 lakh kilometer per second. All these are the properties of light. And now our next question is, what are the phenomena or the phenomena that are exhibited by light? So we will discuss 3 phenomena basically: reflection of light, refraction of light, and dispersion. If we talk in brief, what is refraction? Reflection, if light strikes on a shiny surface, that this is a mirror. When light strikes on this mirror, it bounces back in the same medium. This is known as reflection of light. This ray is incident ray. This point is known as point of incidence. If we draw a 90 degree here, this is normal. And the angle made by incident ray and the normal is angle of incidence. And what will happen to this ray? This ray will bounce back in the same medium like this. And this ray is known as reflected ray. Whole phenomena is known as reflection. This angle is known as angle of reflection. This is the case that we call reflection. And this angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. Also, there is a law that incident ray, reflected ray and normal lie in same plane. And we will see the other cases of reflection. This is the case of plane mirror. If we take a sphere and we take part of this sphere like this and we polish it from one end, this is a type of concave mirror. And if we polish in the inward side, that this type of mirror is known as convex mirror. Concave mirror, this is convex mirror. This is the pole, midpoint of the mirror is known as pole. This portion is known as aperture. And the center of that sphere whose part mirror is known as center of curvature. This is known as radius of curvature. And if we extend this line like this, this is known as principal axis. And there is a rule that if all the rays coming parallel to principal axis after reflection, they pass through a point, that point is known as focus, principal focus. In this mirror, if we take a ray parallel to principal axis, it will go like this. And it seems that it is passing through this point, focus. So this is principal focus. And the length, all lengths are measured from this pole. This PC is known as radius of curvature. This midpoint, this F, P to F distance is known as focal length. And the relation between focal length and radius of curvature is focal length is always half of the radius of curvature. So there can be numericals on this topic or in this formula that radius of curvature is given. And what is the formula for, or what is the value of a focal length? So focal length is always half of the radius of curvature. And also we have to keep in mind the conventions, sign conventions. All the distances are measured from pole. The distances left to the pole are taken as negative, right to the pole are taken as positive. Height upward to the principal axis are taken as positive. Downward heights are taken as negative. So focal length for this concave mirror is always negative. For convex mirror, it is taken as positive. Object is placed here in the left side of the mirror, and we can see different cases in which image is formed by concave mirror and convex mirror. First, we will take the object is at infinity, image will form at focus, and all the ray diagrams, all the possible cases for concave mirror and the convex mirror. So what we observe from the ray diagrams that concave mirror forms always a real image, except one case when object is placed between F and P. In this situation, image is formed behind the mirror, virtual and erect. We can discuss this case because this is the exceptional case in case of concave mirror like this. This is a concave mirror. This is principal axis. This is focus. This is center of curvature. Object is placed here. If we take a ray that is striking on pole, it will go like this. And the ray that is going from center of curvature, it will pass straight without, these rays will not never meet in this direction. So if we see that these rays are coming from a point like this, this portion or this is the image formed, this is AB, this is A dash B dash. So image formed in this case is virtual, erect, enlarged and behind the mirror. Images are of two types, real image and virtual image, and the major difference between these two is real image we can take on screen and virtual image we can't take on screen, and virtual image is always erect and real image is always inverted. So we can see that this object image is enlarged, virtual, erect and on the right side of the mirror. So this is the exceptional case in concave mirror it can be asked. Students, if we relate focal length, radius of curvature, then that ratio is f is equal to r by 2. But if we relate focal length, object distance and image distance, then there is a relation known as mirror formula, and it is 1 by f is equal to 1 by v plus 1 by u. This is mirror formula. We will discuss numericals on this mirror formula. V is image distance, u is object distance, f is focal length. Also, there is a term in this topic that is magnification. Magnification means the ratio of height of image and height of object. Height of image upon height of object, and also for mirrors it is minus V upon U. V is image distance and U is object distance. So this is the brief explanation of the topic reflection. But we will discuss numericals of this topic in our next class. So numericals on this mirror formula, magnification and the formula that relates focal length and radius of curvature. Now come to our next topic, refraction of light. It is a phenomena, or it is we can say that when light goes from one medium to another, it deviates from its original path. It changes its path. Like if we are taking a glass slab and a light ray is striking on this surface, it should go like this, but it changes its path. It changes its path. It can bend towards normal. It can bend away from the normal depending on the medium. If ray is going from rare medium to denser medium, this is air. This is rare medium and this is denser medium, say glass. And ray is entering from rare medium to denser medium, it bends towards the normal, and at this point another refraction takes place. If we draw a normal here, then ray goes like this. So because as it is going from denser to rare again, then it bends away from the normal. So this is the case, means deviation in the path of light when it goes from one medium to another. This is refraction. What is the cause of refraction? Change in the speed of light. When light passes through this air, it has some speed, say it is c, and when it passes through another medium, say this is glass, speed of light in this glass is say v, then this ratio c by v is the refractive index of glass, absolute refractive index of glass. And due to change in the speed of light is the reason behind refraction. So this is a new term, refractive index. Refractive index of glass, it tells how much speed of light decreases when it passes from air to that particular medium, glass and or other mediums. So this is refraction. In this refraction we will discuss lenses. This is a convex lens, this is concave lens. when light rays coming parallel to this principal axis, this is principal axis, all these rays that are coming parallel to principal axis, for this lens it converges the rays, that's why it is known as converging lens. And there is also another lens, concave lens, it diverges the rays and it always forms erect and virtual image. Like, there is also a term known as dispersion. When white light from sun passes through a prism, it splits into seven colors. This is a prism A, B, C, and this ray KL is incident on it, then it divides or it splits into seven colors, vibgior, and this pattern or this the band of seven color is known as spectrum, and the phenomena in which white light is splitted into seven colors is known as dispersion of light. Rainbow is the case of this dispersion. Rainbow is a natural dispersion. So these are the main topics that we have to cover. This is the only theory and in brief explanation of these topics. If we have to solve numericals, we will see how mirror formula is used, how lens formula is used. Lens formula is the relation between focal length, image distance and object distance. This is lens formula, this is mirror formula. You can see the difference here, 1 by V plus 1 by U, in this 1 by V minus 1. We can use mirror formula and lens formula for solving different type of numericals.